everyone, and welcome back to another JoyPad music review on the JoyPad channel. My name is Mike, and I'm the guy that listens to music and talks about it, gives my opinions. I am not a professional musician. I have a hard time considering myself an amateur musician at this point because I'm not involved in a band or anything. I just kind of play on my own time. Today, by request from user Dante, I will be checking out Blackbird by Alterbridge. Now, this is not a reaction because I've heard this song before. Blackbird by Alterbridge. Now, if you don't know who Alterbridge is, lead singer Miles Kennedy and the members of the band are from Creed. So it's basically Creed with a different singer. It's hard to compare the two. They sound pretty different in terms of musical styling in general. Mark Tremonti is a phenomenal guitar player. Miles Kennedy is an amazing singer. And if you haven't heard this song before, I suggest that you buckle in. It's a long one. It's worth it, though. I might have to pause multiple times, or if there's any weird time skips, it's so that the video doesn't get blocked, because that's a thing that can happen. And I don't want to put all this effort into making a video and editing it if it's going to get blocked. So we'll see how it goes. Like I said, I've heard this song before, so I'm just going to listen to it and give my thoughts on certain points and talk about it afterwards. Let's jump in. It's a great progression to start with. Today, a breeze from the distance is calling your name, and furl your black wings and wait. Across the horizon, it's coming to sweep you away. It's coming to sweep you away. You hear that second guitar in the left channel? Very subtle. So not to take anything away from Scott Stapp, who, you know, despite your personal feelings about the man and or your personal feelings about Creed, he's a good singer. A pretty damn good singer, man. But Miles Kennedy, whew, kind of blows him out of the water. Plus, Miles Kennedy can play guitar very well as well. It's something that didn't come into play as much on the earlier Alterbridge albums. This is their second album, but later on you can definitely hear it. So, sorry Creed, Alterbridge has you beaten pretty much every way.
Fly away.
a little bass lick that comes in here that I always pick out that I really enjoy. Not yet. There it is. Just that little bass run right there always catches my ear. I mean, the bass and the forefront of this song, at the forefront of this song, is the guitars and the vocals. So that little bass line always catches my ear. It's something I always listen for, is like creative bass lines. I hate static bass lines. If you watch my videos, you hear me talk about bass. I'm a guitar player and a bassist. I'm trying to do the finger things, but you can't see it. It's off camera. Static bass lines are one of my least favorite things. When the bass just follows the guitar, hate that. Hate it! Guitar solo. Note still going. So, that is Blackbird by Alter Bridge. A thought that comes to mind that I've never really had before making this video is, I spoke about how Miles Kennedy can also play guitar, and I wonder if the solo is actually two separate solos, because you can hear a shift in the tone of the guitar. I wonder if the first solo is actually Miles and the second is Mark. I don't know if that's true. If anyone knows, you can let me know. A lot of times I know if there's two guitarists, my favorite band, Coedie and Cambria, has Travis and Claudio. So, in a lot of songs, they'll trade off solos. Particularly the song Everyone Always Goes to by Coheed is Welcome Home. And the end of that song is just, it's four solos. So it goes Travis, Claudio, Travis, Claudio, but you can hear the difference in their guitar tones. You could hear it here, and I'm wondering if that means that it was Miles and then Mark. I know that Miles is an accomplished musician on his own, even before and after Alter Bridge. Not after Alter Bridge, beyond Alter Bridge, I should say, since they're still active as a band. I wonder if that first solo was him or not. Or vice versa. I feel like the second solo would probably have to be Mark, who is just a phenomenal guitar player. And that's not to take away from the rhythm section. I used to know their names. I feel like one of them is also named Scott. And then Brian, maybe? I don't know. I'm grasping at straws. I don't remember the names of the other members, and I apologize for that, but like, this is just a masterfully crafted song in general. There's a lot of crescendos, a lot of rising and falling. The solos are amazing. Everyone kind of gets their little bits to shine. As I pointed out in the middle of the song, that little bass run always grabs my ear. The guitar solos are phenomenal. The guitar playing in general throughout the verse and the chorus, very good. There's a couple of little, like, unique musical things that happen in the song. At the end of the one of the choruses, the guitar does like a rise and fall pattern, da, 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 and it doesn't quite hit a scale. So it gives you almost like a little bit of an ominous feeling, which is probably what they were going for. This is a very somber song in general. And despite the whole, like, it's, I hate using this word, but it's a pretty epic song. But it still has like a somber whisper, wistful, excuse me, feeling throughout the entire thing. I don't know if I would consider it Alter Bridge's best song. I might be biased. I really like Metalingus because I was a huge pro wrestling fan and on it now, but Metalingus is a track by Alter Bridge from their first album that the wrestler Edge uses as his theme music, and it's a great song. I don't know. They have other, I haven't, honestly, I haven't listened to Alter Bridge in quite some time. So a lot of their library is kind of slipping from my mind, but this is a song that will almost always come to mind if someone says, "Hey, do you like Alter Bridge?" It's like, "Yes, Blackbird. It's an amazing song." It's the title track from their second album. So if you haven't heard this song before and this was your first time hearing it, I hope you liked it. It's a phenomenal song, and it's probably the go-to song I would have to show someone to have them experience Alter Bridge. Is it the best choice? Maybe not. It's kind of a more somber song, but it's just very, very good. Anyways, I hope you like the song. Let me know what you think of it down below. I do take requests. This was a request. And as I said, this is a song I've heard before, so this was a review. If you want to give me more Alter Bridge, I haven't really listened to them past the album after this, which was, I believe, Fortress. And even that one, I don't really remember anything from it. So, if you're going to give me Alter Bridge requests, if you want me to hear more Alter Bridge, I would suggest anything not off the first two albums, because I know those albums better. but whatever, I take requests for anything, so I will likely get to them. Beyond that, I hope that you would check out some of my other music reviews. There are plenty to choose from. And also, if you are into that sort of thing, this is also a gaming channel because gaming and music are my two passions. And on Sundays, you can check out the JoyPad podcast where my friends and I talk about games and why we love them so much. That's it. This is a longer video because it was a longer song. So thank you for watching, and until next time, stay joyful. Bye-bye.